Hi. Bonsoir tout le monde. Merci d'être venu. Merci pour l'invitation à l'équipe de TEDx Cage BS. Moi, je m'appelle Edmund Platt. Sorry, in English. My name is Edmund Platt. That's why I was invited to speak in English as well. My name is Edmund Platt. I'm a business English coach, and I'm originally from Leeds in the north of England. And I am Marseillais d'adoption depuis 4 ans. I'm from Leeds in the north of England, which is 1,556 kilometers from Marseille. It's similar to Marseille. It's the second biggest city in England. 900,000 people live in England, in Leeds. And there are 300 days of rain in England, in Leeds. So it's quite the opposite as well. I come from a business background. I did 9.5, 10 years of sales and marketing in Europe, where I built and created teams. I went from 0 to 100 a few times and had an absolutely fantastic time during this period. And it taught me a lot. I saw a lot of things. Everybody did a lot of things. And I came away that after towards the end of my European business career, I was exhausted and I couldn't do it anymore. I had a bit of burnout and I wanted to do something with my mind. I wasn't getting any real satisfaction from being only motivated by money. And money, and money. It was easy. There came a moment when I had it. I had the money, that was fine. So there was nothing left to really achieve. I had a realization that I needed to change my life and my career, and I became an English teacher. And I retrained, it was fantastic. I started using parts of my brain that I didn't know existed. Because when you're good at sales, it's just sales. When you're good at marketing, it's just marketing. And when you're good at leading teams, you're just leading teams. And I was good at all of that. And I loved doing that. But after 10 years, I became an English teacher. And in 2011, I was on my way to Napoli. I had a job interview in Napoli. And I came to Marseille for 4 days for a holiday en route to Napoli. I was doing autostop. From Leeds to Napoli, fantastic experience. I recommend it to everybody. I'm going to do it again this summer. It's just awesome. I just came back from Arles. I did Arles, Marseille this weekend. It was fantastic on stop. It's perfect. Great fun. And I came to Marseille for 4 days. I thought, whoa, what is this place? Didn't know anything about it. You know, you tap Marseille into Google in England, it's just football. You have to come to see Marseille. You really do have to come and discover it. And there was the beauty, kind of the beginning of a love story, really. So I called Napoli and I said, "Hi, Napoli, there's a problem. I've met Marseille and I think I'm going to stay. Please don't wait for me." So I never actually went to Napoli. Okay, and I had a job with the British Council lined up. And I stayed here and I fell more and more in love. And in any relationship, there's ups and downs, highs and lows. You argue, you cry, you get frustrated, but then you bounce back and you kind of come back stronger. And you have to be strong to live in this town. I think you have to be resilient, you have to be tough. And I love this city so much. And I find there's also a big, big problem in this place. Huge problem that nobody's really sort of taken care of. Nobody's conscious of it. Everyone's conscious of it, but nobody's actually becoming actors yet. Loads of spectators in this town. Loads of spectators in this country. Loads of spectators in England. Everyone's just watching what's going on. I can't watch anymore. I'm not going to sit and watch. That's finished for me. That's over. I can't continue. I'm fed up of walking in rubbish. To quote, I follow a guy in New York. He says, people walk through walk through rubbish like it's snow. They don't even look down, they just walk through it. In Brooklyn, it's terrible. There's a guy in Vancouver, he's called Chris Ralph. And in his street in Vancouver, He was sick of the rubbish. And he said, one day someone's got to clear this up. And he got home and he said, that someone is me. And he did 100 days non-stop of cleaning in his street and became a national hero in Canada. And one day I was fed up of this, and I'm sick of this, and I'm sick of this, and I'm sick of this, and I think you're all sick of this. So it has to change, and we've all got to become actors. Staying spectators is great for sport and TV, but it's your life. You've got to take care of this. We've got to take care of this together. Last August, I went home to England. It was so hot in Marseille. I'm almost Marseillais. I still can't stand the heat. It was too hot last summer. I went back to England, and my house is at the bottom of this park. This park is like Hyde Park. It's huge. And I saw a problem. I was like, what the fuck is going on here? It's the same problem in England. It's not just Marseille. You have to realize that it's not just Marseille. Everyone has to be aware of that. It's not a French problem or a European problem. It's a worldwide problem. And one morning, I picked up a can of Diet Coke. Pour vous, c'est un Coca Light, comme ça vous suivez. I posted on Instagram and Facebook, and I immediately got 40 likes, 80 likes, and lots of comments. Wow, that's great. My husband does the same thing, but it's really embarrassing. What's another one? Great, can you come to Manchester? Manchester's horrible. I was in Leeds. I was back home. That's where I'm from, if you didn't know. And then somebody had written, I knew this guy, George Edward. He'd written, if you can make the Marseillais do the same thing, you're my God. And I was like, okay, I'll take that challenge. So I'd like to introduce you to Georges Edouard Legray. He's the 100% Marseille. Ladies and gentlemen, this man. Cheers, buddy.
Merci, oui. Je suis le 100% Marseillais, là, ici, de l'équipe. Quand j'ai vu ce selfie, tout de suite, j'ai réagi, comme tu l'as dit. J'ai réagi en mettant le présent. Mais tu es en train de devenir, mon Dieu, là ça y est, tu peux te remotiver à fond. C'est en voyant ce selfie que j'ai compris l'impact qu'il pouvait avoir sur nos mentalités, et si on arrive à le faire à Marseille, on va y arriver dans le monde entier. C'est ce selfie qui a fait que je me suis investi avec, on s'est vite réunis, c'était en août que tu as fait ce geste. Début septembre, on s'est réunis, on a trouvé un troisième copain, un troisième larron, qui nous a amené d'autres compétences. Moi, en fait, c'est vraiment ma personnalité, mon histoire, qui a fait que je me suis investi. Je suis, comme je vous l'ai dit, Marseillais. Je suis fils d'industriel dans la chimie à Marseille, puis dans la médecine aussi. J'ai un fils qui est autiste. Et ce fils autiste m'a fait prendre conscience qu'on est dans un cycle qui nous revient. Et il est autiste peut-être à cause de mes gènes, une partie de ce rôle de mélange de mes gènes, peut-être à cause de l'âge du capitaine qui adore la mer Méditerranée et que je suis. Mais aussi à cause de la pollution. Quand un pays comme la Norvège, qui est le premier producteur mondial d'un certain type de poisson, le saumon, avoue depuis 2011 que, surtout pour les femmes enceintes, surtout pour le développement de leur bébé, il faut arrêter de manger leur poisson, on voit l'impact économique, on voit l'impact écologique de cette pollution. Et sur nous-mêmes, sur les générations futures. Et on prend conscience de ça, et c'est ce qui m'est arrivé. Et c'est pour ça que j'ai tout de suite voulu amener mes compétences d'ECM, Community Manager, c'est-à-dire de spécialiste des réseaux sociaux, qu'on les a combinées avec le dynamisme de Eddy, la pêche, le sourire qu'il est. Et donc lui s'occupe du côté RP, relations publiques. Et Romain Joanneau, qui nous a rejoint à ce moment-là, tout de suite voulu mettre ses compétences de DA, directeur artistique, pour amener une image de marque à ce premier geste que Eddy a fait et qu'on a pu, grâce à la puissance des réseaux sociaux, rapidement développer. Donc on a développé ces trois pages. Ces trois pages, Facebook One Piece of Rubbish, Instagram One Piece of Rubbish ou Twitter One Piece of Rubbish. En français, si vous googlisez, vous pouvez faire un déchet par jour aussi. On rassemble tout ça là. Ces trois pages sont devenues, j'allais dire, comme ça qu'on se surnomme, un vrai média, une association 2.0. Une association de bienfaiteurs, c'est ce qu'on disait au départ. On a été rejoint par beaucoup de gens qui se sont reconnus dans ce geste, qui se sont reconnus parce que soit ils le faisaient déjà, soit ils ont eu envie de le faire. L'exemplarité de ceux qui le faisaient déjà, qui ont fait ce selfie de se prendre, ou cette vidéo de se prendre en train de ramasser, qui nous le postent tous les jours, qui animent ces pages, a cet impact phénoménal de boule de neige d'exemplarité. Et c'est ça qui fonctionne complètement, et on est vraiment surpris tous les jours de l'augmentation progressive. On est à 8000 personnes qui nous suivent, ça nous permet d'atteindre certaines semaines 20000 personnes, et ça continue. Et c'est cet effet qui est vraiment le meilleur impact qu'on peut avoir sur l'environnement, en dehors de ce geste simple que tout le monde peut faire, de se baisser et de ramasser un déchet et de le mettre à la poubelle. L'exemplarité. On a, peut-être grâce à nos gueules, ton sourire, notre réseau professionnel et amical, on a vite impliqué des jeunes femmes, parce qu'on était un peu trop de garçons. On a vite impliqué des jeunes femmes, ces blogueuses, ces nouvelles influenceuses, ces prescripteurs qui ont beaucoup de pouvoir sur les réseaux sociaux. Regardez les chiffres du nombre de likes qu'elles génèrent avec une simple photo. Ça aussi, ça démultiplie l'impact qu'on peut avoir avec un simple geste, un geste facile à faire tous les jours. Et je ne vais pas vous parler des médias traditionnels qui ont suivi derrière les blogueurs, mais plutôt de toutes les personnalités qui, elles aussi, grâce à leur audience, j'allais dire, leur visibilité, nous ont vraiment aidés et continuent à s'impliquer, à nous aider tous les jours, à donner encore plus de volume à ce geste tout simple de ramasser. Tout le monde s'y met, tout le monde peut le faire. Et c'est ce qu'on préconise. Derrière tout ça, on a des entreprises, des institutions qui commencent à nous contacter et qui nous invitent dans une exposition, par exemple, comme l'exposition qu'il y a eu à la Villa Méditerranée sur les déchets plastiques et la catastrophe environnementale de ces déchets plastiques qui envahissent nos mers et pourrissent nos poissons. Et ça nous permet aussi d'aller atteindre jusqu'à des ministres. Ségolène qui nous a fait l'amabilité de participer, de montrer cet exemple aussi. Et c'est ça qu'il faut comprendre, c'est que plus le geste va venir de haut, plus tout le monde va rentrer dans ce mouvement et va avoir envie de venir nous retrouver sur notre site qui permet de rassembler tout ça et d'avoir cette vision avec nous du futur, d'une rue plus propre, en bas de chez vous c'est possible, d'une ville plus propre si tout le monde s'y met, et puis d'un futur plus propre. What do you think of this future? What motivates you? And what is the thing that everybody can do and act every day?
I think everyone can do it. I don't know. This is just. I'm here by surprise, and I'm not meant to be here. I picked up a piece of rubbish, posted it on Facebook. 8 months later, Ségolène. I never thought I would have Ségolène Royal in front of me on her knees, picking up rubbish, of course. So we love the fact that we have a cleaner streets, a cleaner city, and a cleaner future. That's our goal. We're going to try and introduce our future is that everyone in this room becomes an actor. There's no more spectators. That's finished. That's game over. You want to sit and watch? Not on my shift. Finished. You can all become, you can all do something. Okay, whether it's brush your teeth in a little bit of water, okay, use your bicycle twice a week instead of none a week. Okay, you can all do something. We can all do something. This year, I'm not buying any new clothes. I'm buying secondhand clothes all this year. I'm not doing any boutiques this year. That's over as well. Okay, so our aim is that everyone, the steps of One Piece, please take this on photo. Get your cameras out. Take this on photo. This is very important. This is what we're all about. That everyone is capable of picking up a piece of rubbish, taking a photograph, or the other way, the selfie, and putting that in the bin, and then posting that act on the internet, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, and being proud of that. Because apparently it's really embarrassing to pick up rubbish, but it's cool to throw rubbish. We're going to change that. That's game over. All right, I'm sorry about that. So the act here is that everyone is capable. Even you guys can do this. Who has Facebook here, please? Everyone, who has Facebook, madam? No? No? Great. Twitter? Instagram? Fine, okay, I'll come back to you afterwards. So, yeah, we can pick up. Afterwards, we're all going to go outside and we're all going to pick up one piece of rubbish. Is that okay with you? Yeah? Is that okay? Superb. Okay, so we have a choice between this is in front of George Edwards' house, by the way, the last week. So we have a choice. We can all make a difference, okay? And the aim of One Piece of Rubbish is to form a human barrier between urban trash, urban rubbish, and nature and the seas, because I don't want to eat bad salmon. I don't want anyone to eat bad salmon. Okay, so we're going to form all together, you and me and him and you, her and her, are going to form this barrier. This is in Cambodia. So people are posting on our website from Cambodia. It's not just Marseille, Paca, France, Europe. It's the world. It's an état d'urgence. I'm following her. She inspires me quite a lot. I'm not afraid to say it. I do follow her. And these are some people in Marseille, a couple. These are some motorbike riders, so they go out, 120 motorbike guys, and they pick up trash. They're not embarrassed. They think it's cool. They think it's sexy as well. That's great. I think it's sexy. Do you think it's sexy? Thank you. It is sexy. That's up. That's La Bonne Mère, Notre Dame de la Garde. We picked up at the end of January. 350 people came to our first event and picked up. 350 people picked up 2.2 tons. On La Bonne Mère, and the Guardian said, thank you very much, that's the first time in 800 years that the Marseillais have cleaned their colline. Il fallait que ça soit en anglais, he m'a dit. Désolé. Okay. And it's all because of my mum. She taught me how to do this. And this guy, he's cool. I like him now. I do. I met his ex. So what we're going to do, the aim of One Piece of Rubbish is very simple. We're all together. Okay, I have 100 ideas. He has 100 ideas. But we're going to do one thing at a time. We're going to create a very, 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 very big human barrier against trash, urban trash and rubbish. And we're going to stop it from going into nature and into the seas. I look forward to going outside and picking up your first piece of rubbish with you, taking a photograph and posting it, and making one piece of rubbish even more viral than it is today, because the future is right now. Thanks.